All right, so let's go over the tools that you're going to need for this job. So the first thing you're going to need is one of these tubing cutters. Now there's these quick ones when you don't have access and you could just clamp it right onto the pipe and start twisting to cut the tube. If you were to go this route, you would have to buy two of these, one for a half inch and one for three quarter. If you have enough room to use this, this works well too. The second thing you're going to need is a reamer. After you cut the tube, there's going to be a sharp edge on the inside, and that's why the reamer is used to shave the inside. Now, if you have a tubing cutter just like this, there's usually a reamer right on the backside where you can use. Another thing you might need are these brushes. I got a 3/4 brush and a 1/2 inch brush. Now this fits inside the tubing and it cleans out the insides. This one hasn't been cleaned. You see the wire brush? Now it's clean copper when you see it shine like that. Next thing you need is either emery cloth, which is pretty much sandpaper, or one of these abrasive mesh. Be careful with these because these take out a lot of copper, so you want to use it gently. Next thing you're going to need is flux and a small brush to apply the flux. Now the flux is going to prime the copper so that the solder will stick. Then comes the solder. You want to use lead-free solder and propane. Either propane or map gas. Map gas burns a lot faster and usually professional plumbers use it so that they could solder a lot of joints really fast. And while you're at it, you're gonna need one of these torch heads. Now you could get one of these torch heads or you could get the one that has a hose attached to it so you don't have to carry the tank around while you're soldering. This is really convenient, and if you're in cramped spaces, this works really well. And that's it with the tools. Let's look at the fittings that you're going to be using. Now for some terminology. So you're going to hear sweat a lot. Whenever you hear sweat or cupped, it means solder. Now these fittings over here are all sweat fittings or cup fittings. Pretty much two pieces go together and these are joined together with solder. Other fittings that you're going to see in the hardware store is going to be threaded fittings or threaded adapters. However, some threaded adapters need to be soldered together first. Now threaded adapters are also commonly called pressure adapters. Now when it's the threaded adapter, the side with the external threads is going to be the male, and the internal threads is going to be the female. Now these right here is called the T couplers. Now they're T because they have three sides you can solder onto, and it comes in different varieties. All three could be 3/4, or like this one is two part 3/4, and then you see a 1/2 inch coming out. This is a three-way 1/2 inch. Now this fitting is perfect if you have an existing line and you want to tee off and make a new line, like a new kitchen or something. You cut this and you solder this one in, and now you could branch off to wherever you need. Now let's go over the copper tubings that you're going to see in the hardware store. Now the two most common sizes that you're going to see is the 3/4 and the 1/2 inch. The 3/4 you're going to see as your main pipe coming into your house. For newer houses, you might see a 1 inch before the 3/4. Now when it comes to your kitchen, restroom, or sinks, anything like that, you're going to see a 1/2 inch. Now for copper tubings, there's actually two types. One is the M series and one is the L series. The M series is the most common in indoors. Now the M is thinner than the L series. This one over here is the M series. Now you see how thin the copper, the sidewalls are. I have a piece of L series. L is usually used for underground if you were to bury this underground. Now for the L series, you're gonna see a blue color. For the M series, you're gonna see red. But this one's all worn out. But when you go to the hardware store, you're gonna see either two types. Now the M will always be cheaper than the L series. As of now, a 10 foot long L series is about $20 at Home Depot. If you were to get the M series, it's $16 for 10 foot. Now the thickness for the M series is about 32 thousandths. For the L series is 45 thousandths, and that's the difference. And the price difference, you're pretty much just paying for more copper. It's not necessary to use the L for indoors, but I've seen some houses that do because they just have the money to spend. All right, let's go over the fittings. Now there's no order to this, I'm just gonna freestyle this. Now these two right here are repair couplings. And I bought these for in case there's a pinhole in one of these pipes and I could actually cut in between it and slip this through. If I were to have a leak right here, and I could cut this right here, slip it in, and I'll solder both joints. So this is a repair coupling. These right here are called elbows. And they're gonna call it sweat elbows or cup elbows. Whenever you hear sweat or cup, that means you have to solder. Now I have a 45 degree elbow right here. Next thing you'll see are the T-fittings. T-fittings will always have three part shaped like a T. Now these are couplings. So if you were to have a leak, you could just cut it just like a repair fitting and slide it through. But one thing that's different about this is there's a notch here. If you were to stick this pipe through, it won't go all the way in. It'll stop right at the notch. That way people will know that they're at the middle. Now one thing weird about this is this one doesn't have a notch. And this is twice as much. This is actually $2 and this is $1. So they spent more labor making this notch and it's cheaper than the one without. Now if you're stuck with this and you want to go through, you can actually use a little file and file this out. See this one without a stopper, you could go straight through. Versus this one with the stopper, you can only go halfway. So be careful at Home Depot, they're gonna mix this up in the box and then you might overpay for one. Now these are called threaded couplings or threaded adapters. The ones with the outside threads is gonna be the male end, and the inside thread's gonna be a female end. And you're gonna see that it's gonna say sweat male adapter, which means it's threaded on one end and the other end needs to be sweated, which is soldered. These are copper straps. Now it's very important to use copper straps. These do make a little noise, so I recommend using the plastic ones or the rubber ones. Now for the plastic strap, this is copper, so if you're joining copper to copper, you're fine. Now if you use regular metal screws, you'll start corroding this strap, so that's why you need the copper nails, copper or brass nails. This right here is a stopper. So for example, if you were to install one of these into one of your lines, and you want an opening for future projects, you want to have another water line, you can put a tube and you solder this cap closed. Once you close this up, it'll seal as if it's just a coupler. Now when you desolder this, now you have a new pipe that you can install and branch off for your whatever you need. Another thing you're going to see is going to be a union. A union is usually two pieces that threads together. This is a dielectric union. So if you have an old house that has galvanized pipes, you're gonna need a dielectric union to separate the copper and the galvanized, or else it'll start corroding on you. I made another video about this, so look it up and it explains a lot more about it. So this piece over here will thread onto your galvanized pipe. This gasket is what's going to separate the galvanized and this copper. For this, you will have to solder your copper into this before installing. Now let's start off with cutting the pipe. Now if you were to have one of these, all you gotta do is slip this in. Now once it sits well, you're just gonna have it snug, not tight, just snug. Now usually spin this backwards by hand so it scores the pipe. Once you see a consistent score, you could twist this just a little bit. And you're gonna see this getting deeper and deeper. And you turn it a little bit more. I'm not even turning, maybe just a little bit. See the groove that I made? Now after you cut this pipe, there's a lot of sharp edges on the side. So what you want to do, if you have one of these, is take one of these, you take this out, you want to clean the inside so it doesn't have any sharp edges, because if water hits that sharp edge, it causes a lot of turbulence, so that's why you want to ream it. Now you use this one when there's lack of clearance. It's pretty simple. You just open this up and say you want to cut it right over here. You just put this in, close it up. Now there's some tension to it, but now you could just start twisting this. So if this is in the wall, you just clamp it on and you just start. It has constant pressure going into the pipe, so as long as you keep turning, it's going to start falling. Just like that. Now this works a lot faster. Now this one doesn't have a reamer for you, and that's why I bought one of these. Now this reamer right here, it pivots. And in this Husky brand, there's gonna be some replacement ones for you once you wear it out. Back to this piece that I just cut, you can see that sharp corner on the inside. Say I want to cap this, I wouldn't be able to cap it. So what you want to do is you ream it. Now, because the sharp part is right here, you want to go clockwise. You don't have to give too much pressure. You'll start seeing the shavings come out. Now if you look over here, there's a taper. Now you're done reaming the inside. Now you gotta clean the outside because you're gonna apply flux on the outside. Now for that, you can use the emery cloth. You just wrap it around and give it a couple turns. Now you want clean copper before you solder. You don't want to solder in this dirty copper. And if you have corrosion inside like this, this is an old pipe, you want to get one of these wire brush. Now if you stick it inside, now you have nothing but clean copper inside. Now you could put whatever fitting you want. Now you could solder it like this, or maybe you want to cap this. Or maybe you want to add a 45 to it to change the angle. Now say I want to add this fitting onto it. So what I'm going to do is just do a quick cleaning of this. Just so that's clean. Test fit it. Fits. Now the next step is to add flux. Wherever the solder is going to be, you want to add flux to there. fitting on. Now you're ready to solder. Now there's a rule, if you're doing a half inch pipe, you don't want to use more than half inch of solder. If you're using 3/4 pipe, you don't want to use more than 3/4 of solder, because if you use too much solder, it might plug up the inside. Alright, now we're ready to solder this. Now let's attach the head to the propane tank. So I'm going to start heating from up top, all around, and I'm going to have the solder right on the right side. Now I'm going to keep heating this, and then once I start seeing the copper start sweating and dripping down, I'm going to touch this corner with my solder, and if it starts melting, I'm going to wait till it goes all the way around and I'm done right there. You see it start bubbling? I pretty much held the solder right here until I see it wrap all the way around. Now's a good time to actually use a dry towel, not a wet one, and wipe off the excess flux. Now this is going to be really hot, so you have to watch out. Now I wiped off the old flux because if you don't wipe off the flux, you're going to get this green corrosion build up over time, and it's going to start eating through your copper really slowly. Now after you're done, you want it to naturally cool down. You don't want to spray anything on it. You don't want to cool it down too fast, because if you cool it down too fast, the solder could crack. Now I'm going to do a top view so you can see what's going on. So I just did another fresh cut right here. Second thing you want to do is ream this. You want to ream, get rid of the sharp corners inside. It's pretty much like sharpening a pencil. As long as you start seeing that taper inside. Clean the outsides. You want to clean where the fitting is going to cover and a little bit more. So this is not enough right here. You want it to show up like this. See, you want to go a little over. You want to wipe off any excess shavings that you have. Now it's time to put on some flux. You want flux on the outside of this. And the inside of your fitting. Then you're going to test fit it. Make sure it bottoms out. Now this is a 3/4 inch pipe, so I'm going to use no more than 3/4 of solder. And I'm going to have the heat this way while the solder goes on the other way. See it start bubbling? Not ready yet. After you're done, you can wipe it off with a dry towel. Wipe off the rest of the flux. Now for the next demonstration, I'm going to be separating this old joint with this pipe. So say this is an old joint and you want to take it out, it's fairly easy. You just have to heat it up, and then once you see the solder start melting, and that's your window to separate it. Once you separate it, and take the heat away, the solder is going to solidify again, so you have to act fast. You start seeing that solder is starting to get liquid form. Now once the solder starts melting, you can separate it really slowly now. Now this is a good way for if you made a mistake and you want to separate it without cutting and shortening it, you can now clean out this copper and try again. And that is it. Thank you very much for watching to the end. I hope you guys learned something from this. The general knowledge is pretty much what I explained. Now if I missed something, please let me know. If you haven't yet, please subscribe to my channel. I'm really trying to grow this channel. If you guys have any questions, please ask me at the comments below. Thank you very much for watching to the very end. And stay tuned for more videos.